Baba wetu katika jina la Yesu Kristo, tunashukuru kwa sababu ya siku ya leo. Asante kwa sababu ya kutuneemesha na kutufikisha mahali hapa siku hii. Uliye mwema na mtakatifu, naomba kwamba tunapolisikia neno lako ukazungumze nasi kwa jinsi tutakavyoweza kusikia na kuwa waaminifu katika neno hili. Katika jina la Kristo Yesu, nitumie kama chombo chako Bwana, na yote atakayefikiwa na sauti hii, naomba Roho wako Mtakatifu kuyeyusha moyo wake. Katika jina la Kristo Yesu tumeomba na tumeamini. Amen. Now, Leo, we are in the 50 days of prayer and fasting. For those who may not be aware, but I know most of us, we are. We began that last week. And at least we said, in a week, look for a day, two or three, or even four, five, and spend time in the presence of God in prayer and fasting. Every day there are prayer items, ambazo tunatuma. And so may God help us to tag along in this season of prayer. And so for that, today I want to speak about the power in prayer. The power in prayer. Let me tell you, and I want to repeat this, I've said this before, prayer is work. Prayer is work. And the work pays. If you're employed somewhere, and before you begin working, these are contracts, maybe somehow you sign, and even if you don't sign in a contract, then there's a discussion that happens between you and your employer. You agree on how much they will pay you, and then they tell you what are your responsibilities, what are your duties, what are you supposed to do, what time are you supposed to get to work, what time are you supposed to leave from work, and many other things that pertains to what you're doing. And so after that, you be faithful to do that. You work responsibly. If it's in a restaurant, you don't break the utensils. So, and many other things. Now, mwisho mwezi ukifika, and you've done your part, now the employer does his part. And his part is to pay you. And when you receive either through a pesa or through the accounts or it is cash, when you look at that money that you have, you see the labor of your hands. See the question? You see the labor of your hands. So you can imagine if you are employed and all what you do is to report at work and sleep at the place of work. Maybe you have a desk. Every day that is what you do, because you know, let me do a kazi at the end of the month. Mimi sifanya na commission, mimi nafanya tu kazi, bora nilipo. Unaenda pale, you're sleeping, all time you're sleeping. There will be time for what we call evaluation. And somebody will evaluate you. And when they evaluate you and they see you're not working well or faithfully, one of the things that will happen is you'll be sent home, you'll be sacked. Or number two, I think I say this sometimes back here. Number two, today that is what most of the employers are doing because of the human rights. Eh? What they are doing is, obviously, you nafanya kazi yako si vizuri. They may not send you home. But what will happen is, wewe utakaa hapo. Unajua kitu unataka kumaktime. Unamaktime, hautafutwa kazi. Lakini wengine wakipata pay rise, wewe haupati pay rise. Wengine wakipatiwa tu tips, wewe uko tu pale pale, una survive tu vile vile. They will never sack you. Because sometimes if they sack you in the name of your lazy, the human rights watakuja, utaenda useme walinifukuza. Na usikute ya kwamba, the employer amekwambia, urudishwe kazi. So, you are paid according to your labor. Work or prayer is work. I want us to, okay, we're going to go to the spiritual part of it, but in the, just looking at it openly, look at it as work. Do you get paid if you don't work? Kuna mtu ulipwa kama hajafanya kazi? Hakuna.
Na kama kuna kitu utapata kama ufanye kazi, then maybe that was just a gift, it was not your pay. Maybe it was just a miracle that God alikuhurumia akaona wacha apewe. But what I'm saying, friends of God, this morning is this, that prayer is work. And lazy people don't get enough of their laziness. In fact, they get little. Iwapo wewe ni mzembe, I have seen before, you know, them in the days tukiwa wadogo. I could see people come home those days. People come home when coffee was coffee. Kahawa ilikuwa kahawa na ilikuwa inalipa vizuri. So my dad alikuwa ametengeneza kahawa yake vizuri sana, vizuri. Na majani chai pia. So when it comes to time ya kuharvest kahawa, so there are people who would come, ile kazi ya kibarua ile ya kila siku. Unakuta kwa shamba we have like 5 or so people or 10 people. And so wanaingia kazi mapema. Na ukiingia tu hakuna hata time ya unaambiwa kuja saa 2. Kuna mwenye anakuja hapo 6 ameingia. Anachuna kahawa, my friend, in a day kuna mtu angechuna hata gunia moja. In a day or even more depending on the vile wamezoea kazi. So baadaye masaa ya mchana hivi wakati kazi imeisha, unakuta ya kwamba watu wale wamekuja wanapimiwa. Wewe ni drum ngapi? Wewe ni mikebe ngapi? And kuna watu walikuwa natoka pale wakiwa wamekasirika sana kwa sababu na si mtu amekasirika, amejikasirikia yeye mwenyewe. Kwa sababu ile pesa anapewa na ile mwingine anapewa naona kama kimeibwa. Kuna mtu anaweza toka hapo na almost 1000 na mwingine anataka na 300. Na shindwa shule. Lakini inategemea na bidii ambayo kila mtu aliweka kwa ile kazi. Let me tell you, even with prayers, I want to believe it is so. That we have to work hard. We have to purpose. The other day I brought the word intentionality. We have to be intentional about prayer. Today we have people who are disregarding prayer so much. In the name of wajeni sura za maombi kila wakati, wajeni sura za fasting kila wakati, watu wakafanya kazi. Sina shida na hiyo, ni ukweli, watu wakafanya kazi. But then prayer is so key. Oh, you want to tell me Jesus was not working? He was. But then as he went all day long, traveling Yesu from one corner to another preaching, that was part of his work. But then after prayer, in the evening, when everybody is sleeping, he could take his disciples, 12 of them, to go to pray. While 12 were kichoka, he takes the 3 who are close to him. They go together in the mountain to pray. All night he could pray because he needed more power. He needed the results of the prayers for him to work the following day. Friends and children of God, what I'm saying is this. It is good for us to understand that prayer is work and it is important. And if we want to get to the next level, even in our relationship and our deep relationship with God, kindly let us take prayer so seriously. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Unaona venye unakuwa umechukulia hiyo job yako au serious? Yaani you're so serious ya kwamba unataka mchezo na kazi yako. Hata ukipigiwa simu ukiwa job, you're like, now ni kama inanisumbua. You really don't want to get disturbed. I want you to take prayer that serious. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Commit yourself to prayer. The way you wake up in the morning and you want to report to work, my friends, I want to encourage and challenge us. Let us make prayer a priority in our lives. I've always told you what propels you keeps you there. What takes you up there keeps you there. We are a church that was born out of prayer. Balance it yourself. And that is why you actually realize we really emphasize so much on prayer because we know and I know it works. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. If Jesus lived a life of prayer, Bwana, wewe ni nani? Mimi ni nani? And he was the Son of God. In fact, the Father had all that the Son needs. The Son really didn't have to fast. In fact, 40 days and 40 nights he was in the place of prayer fasting. But I thank God because he was the nature of man and he was praying and fasting because he really needed to teach us and to show us that it can happen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. So, before I speak on prayer, and I'm not sure if I'll finish this today, but if I don't finish, then we continue next week, probably.
I want us to understand intercession. Intercession is the most basic. And intercession is not just a prayer of 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and you're done. Intercession, listen, it is prayer which flows out of relationship and fellowship with our Heavenly Father. Intercession is prayer which flows. Ombi au maombi yanayo tokana na uhusiano na ushirika na Baba wetu wa mbinguni. So tunapoomba, kuna hali ya kitu inaitwa uhusiano. Lazima tukue na uhusiano ya kwamba mimi na Mungu niko na uhusiano ya kwamba mimi ni mtoto wake kwa sababu nimefanya Kristo Yesu kuwa Bwana na Mwokozi wa maisha yangu. So I have built that relationship. I am not talking to a stranger. Now, prayer is talking to God, all right? And when you're talking to God because you have a relationship with Him. Most of us, we have encountered this. Last week I was going to a prayer meeting somewhere on, was it on Monday? Yes, on Monday. I'm a true guy in a certain church. So, in the election to God, when I was almost that area, nikashindwa ni hii barabara ama ni hii. So I saw some ladies, some two girls pass. Then I was like, "Habari zenu?" Aniangalia tu. Mmoja akasema mzuri hiyo tu shiko pana. Nikamuuliza, "Kwa hiyo hapo niko wapi?" Waliniangalia tu hivi wakiendaga. Wakiendaga. So what came to me was because I'm asking her for direction for how, lakini hatujuani. So for them, they even afraid of talking to me. Kwa sababu atawajui ni nani. Na sio kwamba nimevaa kama pastor. Unajua ningekuwa nimevaa tai nafikiri wange ama kola wange simama. But because we don't have a relationship with them, they were just so casual. In fact, they didn't even want to talk to me. That was happening because we didn't have a relationship. But you can imagine if it is Dorcas here. Na nimesimama Dorcas barabara ya kwenda iko wapi? Na akaniambia iko hivi na hivi because tunajuana. So we are talking from a point of relationship. So intercession or prayer or intercession prayer, maombezi ya kuombea watu na vitu inatokana na uhusiano na ushirika. Now the relationship, fellowship or relationships comes before fellowship. You first relate, unajuana kwanza na Mungu, alafu unatengeneza uhusiano na Baba wetu wa mbinguni. Bwana asifiwe sana. And so from that conversation with him, I am ongea na Baba wetu, we found out or we discover his will. Now, in the relationship that we make with God, now we are talking about prayer, remember? In the relationship that we make with God, now, because of this relationship and the fellowship, we know each other. All right? We know each other. And because of knowing each other, I get to know what so and so, you know, what I want and what he wants. Allow me to give an example of this couple here. My brother Ben, wakati nilikuwa na called our sister there, Nancy, he didn't know much about Nancy. Nancy didn't know much about Ben. But it was out of that relationship, they continued to build it pole pole, kujenga uhusiano pole pole. Hapo ndio walikuja kujua, Ben alikuja kujua zile vitu ambazo Nancy anapenda na zile ambazo wapendi. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. One time, I think I said here, when I got married, nilikuwa napenda tu mchezo kidogo kidogo sana. And I think, ni kama sijamaliza na watu. Okay. Sijika nimaliza na nimaliza. Anyway, that's the story for another day. So nilikuwa napenda tu mchezo kidogo. So I would just, nina, no, na talk to give it to with my wife. Eh? You know, una mko tu mama, whenever unasikia tu na joke, unasikia kutikitiki, you know? Ile kufanya fanya hivi ama kuistua tu mtu hivi. Ah, we then may realize this is to my brother. I didn't know before wakati nimeona, but when I got married sasa nimeanza kufanya hivi.
Hizi vitu wapeni. What I did, I stopped. Sasa kwenye watoto walikuja Yesu unafanyaka na wao. Na wanapenda kija kwa nyumba baba tikitiki hiyo vile tu hivi. Mnazungua kwa nyumba mkicheza. And they like it. And because I also like it, sisi wote tunaflow. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. So, when you have that relationship, you build a fellowship, then you get to discover what this person wants. And that's what I'm saying. After our conversation with God, we found out or we discover his will. Tunajua mapenzi yake. Anachotaka na kile ambacho ataki. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. So as we fellowship with God, we get to know him, and he knows. Actually, for him, it's not about us, he wants to know us. He already knows us. Yeye ndiye ametuumba. Ukitaka kujua mtoto uliza mama, mama anamjua vizuri sana mama baba. Wewe unaweza kuwa mjui, but aliyemzaa anamuelewa vizuri sana. Now, it's also good to understand that in the place of prayer, in the place of prayer or intercession, we are laborers together with God. Sisi ni watenda kazi pamoja na Mungu. We are laborers with God. Another thing about intercession is that intercession is asking or inviting God to do what we find out or what we discover he wants to do on earth. Intercession is asking or inviting God to do what we find out or what we discover he wants to do on earth. In this way, we become laborers with God. We become laborers with God. So when God is working, we are also working. When God is working, we are also working. Open first Corinthians. First Corinthians and chapter 3. First Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 9. Bible says this. For we are both God's workers and you are God's field. You are God's building. Sisi ni watenda kazi na Mungu. Sisi ni jumba lake Mungu. Sisi ni jumba lake Mungu. So we are working together with God. And so prayer based on a knowledge of what God desires is what is described in the Bible as praying according to the will of God. Amen. Now let me tell you, I want you to follow me because kuna vitu nitasema kule chini, if you didn't get them here, unaweza potea. So kindly follow me closely. Follow me closely. So prayer based on the knowledge of what God desires is what we pray, or what we call in the Bible, praying according to the will of God. And I would encourage you, because there are several scriptures which are so, but for the interest of time, just be noting them down. Romans chapter 8 and verse 27. This is what the Bible says. Verse 27. And the Father who knows all hearts knows what the Spirit is saying. For the Spirit pleads for us believers in harmony with God's own will. With God's own will. So it is good for us to understand that as we are praying, we don't just pray unapoanza kuomba unakuja hapo unafika kona ile unajikuta umeruka kule umeruka kule umeenda kule haujui exactly what you are praying for. You don't know if it's God's will or not. I'll be showing us sometimes the prayers we are making and we really, this is what we want, eh? This is what hindi unataka, lakini kumbe Mungu hataki hiyo. Umesisitiza. Umesema hii ndio nataka lakini Mungu hataki. But then it comes a time and God realizes, wewe ndio ulikufunza sawa basi chukua. Akishakupatia kile ambacho umekuwa umesisitiza sana na yeye hakutaka, huko mbele ni unarealize, kumbe Mungu alikuwa ananifunza. Kumbe Mungu alikuwa ananiongelesha na nilikuwa nafunga masikio. Kumbe hii nilifanya, kumbe hii kwa mapenzi ya Mungu. So it's good to follow closely and also get to understand that when we are praying, we are laborers together with God,
and it is good to know what God is doing, we do it. What God wants, it is what we need to go with. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. There's what we call God's sovereignty and man's responsibility. Ukuu wake Mungu na jukumu la mwanadamu. Have I not told you here that in the place of prayer, there is God's part and there is your part? Si ndio kweli? Sehemu yake Mungu ipo, and I want to say maybe ni ya kutimiza, na sehemu yako ni ya kuuliza. Now, swali ni je, unapouliza, unauliza mapenzi yake Mungu au ni mapenzi yako? Now, kuna vile unaweza kuwa mapenzi yako ndio haya, lakini swali ni je, mapenzi yako inaandamana ama inaambatana na mapenzi yake Mungu? Na mapenzi yako ikiambatana na mapenzi yake Mungu, jua hilo itakuwa rahisi kupata. Na hata kama itakuwa sasa, be sure it will come. Lakini wapo mapenzi yako ni haya na ya Mungu si hayo, utang'ang'ana hapo, utaomba hapo, utafanya na haitawezekana. Maybe some of you here, you've been trusting God for kuajiriwa, for example. Na unaamini Mungu unataka kuajiriwa mahali fulani, na hiyo wewe, hiyo ndio ombi lako. Kumbe Mungu hataki uajiriwe, anataka uajiri. Na huko hapo umeng'ang'ana, mimi nataka kufanya kazi kwa hiyo kampuni kubwa, mimi nataka kufanya kazi mahali fulani, mimi nataka kufanya kazi fulani ndio nipate experience. Mungu anakuambia you don't need experience. Wewe ingia kwa biashara, ajiri wengine, nitakupatia experience. Praise the name of the Lord. So it is good for us to understand that in the place of prayer, there is a God's sovereignty and there is a responsibility of a man. Hallelujah. John chapter 15. That one I have to read. John chapter 15. And verse 7. Bible says this. But if you remain in me and my words remain in you, you may ask for anything you want. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. You may ask for anything you want and it will be granted. If you remain in me, ukiishi ndani yangu na neno langu likae ndani yako, utaweza kuuliza chochote utakachohitaji. Now, I want you to know that katika hiki ambacho utakachohitaji ni kile ambacho kimo ndani ya mapenzi yake Mungu. Hicho ambacho umeitisha na kimo ndani ya mapenzi yake Mungu, hicho haitakuwa na wasiwasi ama mng'ang'ano yoyote Mwenyezi Mungu kukupatia kile. Praise the name of Jesus. And so Jesus, all the time he referenced the will of God, his Father. Alitamani kufanya mapenzi ya Baba yake. You remember one time when Jesus has gone through so much of trials and temptations, and akopale, which mountain is this? Mahali ambapo ameuzwa na Judas Iscariot. He's in that place and he's praying. Na anaomba because anajua, actually he foresaw, he knew that what I'm just about to go through, it is not easy. Kupigwa mijeredi, kudungwa visu sijui nini, misumari, it is not easy. But then he went to the place of prayer. And when he's kneeling down there, the Bible says he told God, his Father, Father, if it is your will, if it is your will, iwapo ni mapenzi ya hii kikombe cha uchungu huu, niondole. Bwana asifiwe sana. Niondole hii Bwana, ni chungu. Isiwezi, lakini sio mapenzi yangu, mapenzi yako. Bwana asifiwe sana. That was Jesus. That was Jesus. He's the Son of God. He said, this is not about me. It is about you. I'm just getting this right now that sometimes we pray very selfish prayers. Very selfish prayers. That where God is not even involved. That we want to get this and that and that. And we have not even sought God. Hatujatafuta
ukutujwe ini yake Mungu ama hii ni bwewe tu. Hii ni ile tu mimi nataka. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana.
But Jesus made a prayer, a very passionate prayer. In fact, when he was there, you could tell it is heavy because he was sweating. And he was not shouting so much like some of us do when we are praying. He's there making a prayer, but because of the heaviness, because of the pain that he knows he's going to experience out there, he's saying, God, eat this, remove this cup from me. Iki kombeni ondole. Ila sio kwa mapenzi yangu, ila kwa mapenzi yako.
Mapenzi ya Mungu ilikuwa ni kwamba siku ondoe hicho kikombe cha mauti cha machungu ilikuwa akipitie.
And you can imagine Jesus with all that pain, his God was like, you are going to go through it because of my children, because of my people on earth, because of my church in the nation of Kenya, because of my people living in Ugata Rongai. He knew it. That is why he said his son Jesus.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana.
So Jesus always submitted to the will of the Father. Yesu alinyenyekea chini ya kusudi au mpango wa baba yake. Siku hizi tunaongea kuhusu kupangwa. Yesu alikubali kupangwa na baba yake na akapangika.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
He submitted to the will of God. How many of us today are ready to submit to God's will? To God's direction. Last Sunday we said, is it last Sunday? I think, yes. That when it comes to walking in obedience to the word of God, it has to be only. That is why God was talking to Joshua when he was taking the mantle of leading the children of Israel into the promised land. And God was like, as I was with Moses, I will be with you. But then you have to be ready to obey the word, the book of the law, and meditate upon it day and night. Hakuna kuacha hata moja. Na ndio tulikuwa tunasema, there are many times there are some people who want to obey partially. Partially nusu. Kuna hii naona hii inanifeva. Hii inanifeva. Hii sio chungu. Hii ninaweza. Hii ni kidogo. Hii hainiumizi sana. So hii sina shida nayo. So you want to obey as long as you are comfortable. But sikona tusaidie. If it is walking in obedience to his word, tuifanye fully because he knows he is able to help us to go through the same. Now, the reason as to why God the Father allowed the Son to go through this pain is because he knew he will overcome it. He knew he will not die. I am sure that God knew that his son will not just die because of the pains that he's going through. The reason for him to die was because he had to die for the salvation of man. Afe alafu afufuke, and the world to know that indeed there was a God in heaven.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana.
The Father, however, that is God the Father, depends on him. On him, who, Jesus, to be the one through whom his will shall be done here on earth. The Father depended on Jesus, his son, to fulfill his will here on earth. I want you to listen to this. That the Father, that is God, our Heavenly Father, would not in any way enter the arena of man's dominion. What is the arena of man's dominion? It is earth. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. God gave man what we call dominion, to take domain, kumiliki inchi ama ulimwengu. Hapo ndio mwanadamu alipewa uwezo wa kutawala. Lakini dhambi nayo kupitia adui, kupitia ubinafsi wa mwanadamu, kupitia disobedience ya mwanadamu, he fell into sin. But then, what we say that God would not in any way enter the dominion of man without, note this, without being invited in prayer to do so. Let me say this. God is not a gate crusher. Jesus is a gate crusher. You know gate crushers? Yes. You know what you have to do with your life because you have to do with your life. During my wedding, and Favor here can tell,
we were supposed to be already in our church. But then that night kukanyesha sana. Kuliponyesha sasa niko kwa koro kada ni wale wanajua Yesu. So tulikuwa tumekatent huko na tukajua huko sasa kuko na security now. So kukanyesha matenti zikavunjwa na mvua. So we had to take back now the wedding back to the church. So unajua pale tulikuwa tunajua market crash ni ngumu kuingia because in institution na maskari watakuwa pale sio wezi ingia. So tulipopeleka kwa church. So this is church. In the church you don't say wewe usiingie wewe ingia. Everybody gets in. Market crash walikuja. Vizuri. Sasa watu wabea mchele tu. Wanaweza sifia sana. Gate crashers come without an invitation. Right? Zero point in Christmas, gate crash. See you. Unaingia tu. Unaongoka vitu na unaenda zako. But then what we are trying with God is, yes, he can come at his own time because he is not limited. Him akiamua anakuja. But there are things or there are some places you not just come without an invitation. And this invitation is invitation through prayer.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Through prayer.
Mark chapter 6 verse 10. May thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. This is a prayer that Jesus was teaching his disciples one time. They were together and then one of the disciples comes to Jesus. Na namwambia Yesu, "Hey, nitufunze kuomba." And you know, I'm talking about prayer and somebody out there would be asking, how have people been taught about prayer? Don't they know how to pray? Have they not been charged all along? Hawa wanafunzi wenye kwa Yesu na Yesu wana mmoja wake anakuja kumwambia tufunze kuomba. Walikuwa na Yesu wakati mgani? So walikuwa na Yesu for some time. But somehow, they don't know how to pray. Jesus is going to pray, and they are there. Most of them, wanaenda tu kuomba hivi. Yesu tu akitoka tu kidogo hivi. Inakuwa ni kama wanafunzi na deputy kwa shule, ama teacher. You know, you're in class. The moment the teacher tu ametoka tu hivi, noise makers. Yeah? Hapa na pale, hapa na pale. Na mwalimu akitu tu hivi, everybody ni mnyamavu. Akitoka tu hivi, unaanza kusikia. So, this is what was happening with these disciples. Yes, we talk about it, most of them just sleep. They were like, how am I doing? One of them. But then one of them told Jesus, hey, teacher, father, I mean Jesus, teach us how to pray. And so he began to teach them. And at one point he told them, when you pray, see this, thy father, thy wish at heaven, no. Then thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. So Jesus, even in his teaching, and this is what we are saying about today, even in the teaching, he is teaching the disciples to pray according to the will of God. Therefore, prayer involves knowing God and his will. If you forget anything, don't forget this. Prayer involves knowing God and his will. Now, knowing God is now the relationship, and you know him through the relationship that you make and the fellowship. Now, it is out of the relationship and the fellowship that you get to know what he needs. And you see, the fellowship has to do with spending more time. Now, relationship is already you know him. So, for you to get to know now his will, there has to be fellowship. For example, I know my brother Marvin, that is relationship. But fellowship, I need to spend more time with him for me to know him, what he likes and what he does not like. That is now the relationship for me to know his will. So what we are saying, prayer involves knowing God and his will. Knowing God and his will. Now another thing about prayer, for that prayer now to come true or to be heard or to be fulfilled, it requires one that we be humble. And when we are talking about being humble, it has an aspect of truth. It has an aspect of us being real. You don't go before God, you know it. So you have to be true to God. He knows. In fact, even before you go to him, he knows you need it. Has your child ever come to you? You know the particular thing that he or she needs. And you know it, and you know it's your responsibility to do. But you're not doing it until they come to you and ask. That is when you give. Today in the morning, we had a service at Peter's, and I was talking about ask. I mean, go back and ask. That was what I was talking about. Go back and ask. And we are referring to Luke chapter 15 about the story of the prodigal son. Now, in verse 12, when the prodigal son, one of the youngest sons, realized that I'm of age, I need to go. What does the Bible say? He went to the father and he told the father, now I ask that you give me my what belongs to me. And the father, the Bible says, the father divided between the two sons. The young one, when alitisha akapewa, and he went. Now, how he spent his money is a story for another day. But my point is this: the father had all that the sons needed, and so one of them went and asked. Don't you think the father knew that they needed, but he was not giving because anajua hii ni yao tu. Wakifika wakati wa kuhitaji, I'll give them. So one of them comes and the father gives and he goes. Huyu mwingine akuuliza na kidi mali iko. So it requires that we humbly but faithfully ask or invite him to bring forth his purpose here on earth. So prayer thereof involves God, knowing God and his God and his will. And it also requires that we humbly but faithfully ask him to bring forth his purpose here on earth. But this was a fear, son. Now let me just read out the what I've written here, that the world is our God-given domain of responsibility and authority. The world is our God-given realm of responsibility and authority. Therefore, God waits for our prayers before acting on our behalf. God waits for our prayers. Mungu anangojea maombi yetu. God awaits for our prayers before acting on our behalf on earth. Now, there are three things that happen when we pray in the will of God. I want you to note this. Three things happen when we pray in the will of God. Remember, the point is, when we are praying, every prayer, for example, you're praying for, a sick person. Okay? And perhaps it is not, and allow me to say this, it is not the will of God for this person to get healed or even to continue living on earth. And you're there praying, God, heal this. And maybe God does not want to heal. A story is given of this particular lady. He has a family, and she has an elderly, her own father and mother. Very elderly, 90 plus. And so, huyu mama, lazima angeletwa sasa kwa huyu mama, dada, wakae naye kwa boma. Wakae naye kwa boma kwa sababu sasa kwenda nyumbani, it is too much for her. Lazima angemleta hapa because now, this mama is getting so old that hakuna kitu anaweza jifanyia. Ni wale sasa amerudi to square one. Like these babies now that huyu, hakuna kitu anaweza jifanyia, na kufanyiwa pampas, kukua fed, nothing. So this mother is there so weak and anahitaji kufanyiwa kitu. And sickly also. So this lady is like praying for God's will. I mean, anaomba Mungu usiku huyu asiende mponye. But then the mama was becoming a burden to the family.
Even the relationship now between this lady and the husband is getting a bit sour. Vitu haziendi vizuri, ni muzigo. Uyu mama lazima akuwe na mtu 24 hours. Akiwa melala kuna mtu wako pale. All through kumtuza. So the lady every time they go to pray, Father, we pray that you heal. We pray that you heal our mama. Na ni vizuri kuomba hivyo. But then one time, a servant of God came. So they began to pray. And they began to pray in the spirit. They prayed in tongues. Wakachapa dimi pale. They prayed. Now for the prayer, the servant of God says, ask them. Now let me ask. You people, are you praying the will of God or you're praying for your mother to get healed? Aka mama akasema mimi tunaomba mama apone asikie vizuri. But then the servant of God says, I feel that we need to pray God's will. Either this mama to get healed or even to leave us, to just release her. Actually, the man of God was like, what he was feeling in his spirit is that release this mama. Just release her. You're the one who is holding her. God sees you're the one who is holding her to go. Should have gone. It was hard for this mama to listen to that. But nonetheless, akatid. So, what can be home? Wakiomba, they are like, God, we pray according to your will about our mom. We are ready to release her. Haikupita wiki, the mother rested in peace. What was happening? The family had drained so much resources because they were drained. Vitu mingi sana zikatumika, kazi ifanyiki vizuri, kwa sababu wameshikilia hii ni yetu. Hii huyu mama ni wetu basi yetu. But the will of God was like, huyu mama alimwachilia kitambo sana, lakini the family is holding. So, one of the things we are talking about is praying in the will of God. Now, in a survey, because in these 50 days of praying and fasting, I am believing God that we are going to have results. And for us to get results of our prayers, ni lazima tuombe venye Mungu anataka. Sio venye tunataka, tuko na mahitaji yetu, tuko na matamanio yetu ndio, lakini swali ni je, matamanio hayo yameambatana na Mungu? Praise the name of Jesus. So three things happen when we pray the will of God. Number one, we will pray God's prayers. Tutaomba maombi ya Mungu. We will not pray our prayers. In fact, from today, I want us to start praying God's prayer. And God's prayers is yale ambayo Mungu anataka. Ile ambayo Mungu amepitisha hiyo ni sawa, ombeni nitapeana. And you see the Bible says, seek at the door and seek and we shall find. Knock at the door shall be opened and then seek and you will find. Yeah? Tafuta utapata, omba na utapewa. Lakini ukifanya kulingana na mapenzi yake Mungu. So, three things happen when we pray the will of God. We will pray God's will. Number two, we will feel God's feelings. Tutahisi hisia zake Mungu. God has feelings as well. And so when we pray according to his will, as we are praying, we feel this is God. Hiji Mungu anahisi. Mungu anataka hivi. So mawazo yako, hisia zako, sio za huzuni, sio za kicheko, ni za Mungu, za furaha, vile ambavyo Mungu anataka mambo iwe. Kutoka siku ya leo naomba Mungu atusaidie tuache kuomba na kitu inaitwa binafsi. Have you ever heard of somebody who says, please don't do this for us, for me. Please don't do this for me. Please, you know, like this mama who is now dying. People are like, please mama, don't die this for me. Ukikufa mimi sijui nitakaa wapi. Sijui nitafanya nini, nitaishi na nani.
You know, that's a bit of a selfish prayer. Okay, it's a good one, but it's more of selfish. So, wewe utaki apone kwa niaba yake, unataka apone kwa niaba yako. Ndio uendelee kupata kile umekuwa unapata pale.
Praise the name of the Lord. So when we pray according to God's will, we will feel God's feelings. Number three, we will think God's thoughts. When we pray according to the will of God, mawazo yetu itakuwa ni mawazo ya Mungu. Amen. Anachowaza Mungu kuhusu future yetu, hivyo ndivyo tutakavyokuwa tunawaza. Even when the devil brings death on your face, and you think about what God thinks about you, even at that point of death, when you think about what God thinks, then He gives it to you. Because that is His will.
Bless us if you are son.
So as we are praying to God through His Son now, we need to desire that we are praying prayers of power or with the power. Maombi tutakayokuwa tunaomba, tunaomba maombi ya nguvu, yenye iko na nguvu. Na hizo ni nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
What is your situation?
We don't just pray aimlessly. So he's talking about the power in prayer.
The power in prayer.
Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. This is what the Bible says. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God. Not that scripture. 26, sorry. Yes, 26. 26. And the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. Romans 8, 26. And the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. For example, we don't know what God wants us to pray for. But the Holy Spirit prays for us with groanings that cannot be expressed in words. The Holy Spirit prays for us with groanings that cannot be expressed with words. Umwaienda kuomba. Bara sana. Aga ona. Umwaienda kuomba. And you are so deep in prayer until unajikuta you, yani, unaisi, you are not in this world. You've gotten to prayer sometimes, you get into speaking in tongues. Sasa unakuta the tongues sio hizo, unasikia ni kama unalia. We do not know, then it is said that we will be taught. And I thank God because of this disciple who went to Jesus and told Father Jesus, teach us to pray. I know you're here, and this is a prayer. I want you to pray after this, as I'm coming to the end of this session today. That God, Holy Spirit, I do not know how to pray. Sometimes you go to pray and you are just confused. Unaanza kuomba, unakuta kuomba. Sasa when you start praying, you start remembering your problems and how they began and how they cannot be sorted. And so the moment you think they cannot be sorted, unapoteza nguvu ya kuomba. Sasa unakaa angalia wengine wakiomba ama usikize wengine wakiomba. Have you found yourself there? Wewe unanyamaza tu usikize wengine wakiomba. And the devil is so cunning. And that is why I say, pray according to the will of God and waiting on the Holy Spirit and allowing the Holy Spirit to teach you. Because if you don't allow the Holy Spirit to teach you, ndio unakutanga kuomba, kuomba inakuwa ngumu. Unakuwa na kidogo tu ya kusema, na hili unasema tu ni asante. Na asante ni vizuri kusema, lakini unakuta God has done so much, but we have all 20 minutes of saying, telling God thank you, but we have no content. Hatuna vitu za kumwambia. Let me tell you, the devil is a liar. The devil does not want you to connect with God. He does not want you to receive what prayer can offer. Hallelujah. The point is to ask, but how are we asking? Praise the name of Jesus.
Now, it's only if we have the Holy Spirit, I think I've said that, it's only if we have the Holy Spirit enablement in prayer, can we obey the command given by Paul in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18. The Bible says, keep on praying in the Spirit. Keep on praying in the Spirit. Endeleeni kuomba kila wakati katika roho. Keep on praying in the Spirit. 6 verse 18. Pray the Spirit at all times and on every occasion. Stay alert and be persistent in your prayers for all believers everywhere. Persistent meaning you don't stop. If my time of prayer it is 6 in the morning, tomorrow 6 in the morning I am there to pray. And if I've said I'm going to pray for 1 hour, I am consistent to that 1 hour and I am faithful to that 1 hour of prayer. The other day we began this year a session of prayers here every day. 7 in the morning, at, 8 in the morning to 9, 1 hour. Now in these 50 days, we are saying 7:30 to 9. If we can be faithful and be consistent in that 1.5 hours of prayer, my brothers, sisters, you'll be surprised at what God will be doing in your life. And personally, I've purposed in my life, and I've said this before, and I want to repeat it. I want to commit myself more and more to God. I want to walk in power. I want to preach in power. I want to teach in power, not of ugali. And this one can be found in the place of prayer. The Bible says, keep on praying in the Spirit. Be alert, watch and pray. Very fast, I give you very fast different forms of prayer. Different forms of prayer. Now, there are many ways we can approach God in prayer, and all of them are important and their place in our lives and also in the walk of a believer with God. Different forms of prayer. Prayer number one, kuna kitu inaitwa contemplative prayer. You know, ile whereby you've given yourself, you've devoted yourself to prayer life. You've contemplated, you've thought about, I'm going to live a life of prayer. I'm going to pray anytime, anywhere, anyhow. You know, and these are they are devoted to these people or such believers who do these prayers. They are devoted to knowing God and relating to His will through meditation, quiet thought, and prayer. Contemplative. So you're really thinking about God. Unawaza sana kuhusu Mungu, una meditate neno lake, na unaomba tu mahali umetulia. And these people are so good into praying for other people. You sit down, una contemplate. Contemplate is more of thinking, eh? Unawaza so and so, unamuombea. Unawazia jambo fulani, unaliombea. Hiyo ni nzuri. And it's an important prayer, and it is good to have it in your life more often. With your job, you can open your mouth and speak a blessing, speak a prayer over one or two things about people, about yourself, about situations and all that. The other thing, the other form of prayer is what we call prayer books, prayer. These are prayers that are read out there. Prayers that are in prayer books. Some of us, we are coming from churches whereby there are kuna kitu inaitwa liturgy. Maombi ambayo imeandikwa mahali, so every Sunday lazima iombwe. Even God hears such kind of prayers. And where we get these prayers in the Bible, sana sana is in the book of Psalms. Psalms is a prayer book. Have you noticed that? Ukisoma Psalms, it is more of prayers. Ni maombi mengi sana imejawa pale. Kina chorus, they pray so much to God through what is written there. So when such prayers are read with a heart that is truly seeking after God,
The Holy Spirit can bring the life of the living word to the written word. If you read, and I've done it personally, the times I've gone to pray and in a fungua awesome, ni unaweza fikiria ni vile najua Kiingereza mingi. Unaweza fikiria mtu ni msomi lakini kumbe anasoma. And it is you feel kuna mahali unafika. Ukifungua tu Psalm 103, ukifungua Psalm 120, unaisoma, it's a prayer. So there are prayers that can be written and they are prayed and God hears. Si tumeziona national meetings. Unakuta mchungaji ametokea pale na maombi hajafunga macho sema let us pray. Anaanza nashindwa kanaomba kweli. Who are those people who never believe those prayers, but they are prayers anyway. Bwana asifiwe sana. There's also what we call directed prayers. Maombi yaliyoongozwa. Directed prayers. These are the prayers where you repeat after what so and so is said. Many of us have had someone help us or direct us in our first prayer. Kuna watu ambao wakifunzwa maombi wanaambia rudia nyuma yangu. Na wanajikuta ya kwamba wamejua kuomba. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. All of us, we have done that prayer, I believe. The directed prayer. Si kuna mtu alikuombea ukafanya ombi, you know, the so-called sinner's prayer. Wakati ulikuwa unaokoka. Si kuna mtu alikuongoza kwa ombi. Na ukaokoka. A story is told of one day at the end of a service, a young man akauliza mgeni, you know, he asked a visitor who had come to church if he wanted to receive Christ as his savior. And so this visitor said, no, I don't believe I am ready yet. And then the young man then asked, would you want to know how you will pray when you are ready? I mean, do you know how you can pray when you are ready to receive Christ? So the guest said, no, I guess I don't know how I would pray. So the young man asked, would you like to know what you'd pray the moment you're ready? He said, yes, I believe I would want to know when I'm ready what I can pray. So the young man said, now here is a prayer that you should pray when you're ready. So the young man told him, just repeat after me. He then led the visitor in a simple prayer, a directed prayer of repentance. So he told the visitor what to say, what to pray, to invite Jesus to come into his heart and to be, you know, into his heart as Lord and Savior. So as the visitor repeated this prayer, because now the young man alianza kusema hiyo prayer, as the visitor repeated that prayer, tears began coming down from his eyes. His face lit up with joy. The Holy Spirit melted his resistance and Christ came into his heart. And he was truly born again that particular time. So God honors all kinds of prayers. Yule jamaa hakuwa tayari kuokoka, lakini sababu ameongozwa kwa ombi, akaokoka. Moyo wake Mungu akamfanya mwepesi na he received Jesus Christ as Lord God and his Savior. The last one is what we call the prayer items or lists, listed prayers. Hizi ni zile ambazo tumezoea. Tunaenda mahali kwa mkutano ya like, what are we going to pray for? Tunaweka mahitaji yetu yote pale, tunayaweka, and then we get into prayer. All these are important, and it is good for us as a church, as families, you know, friends and all that. Whenever we meet, choose any one of them, but then pray. But then the question is this. Are we in those four forms of prayer? Are we praying them in accordance to what God's will is? Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. I want to stop at that. And then next week, we are going to look into why many times we are praying and our prayers are not answered. Is it that God does not want to answer? No. Is it that God does not want to listen? No. The Bible says that this is the confidence that we have in approaching God, that when we pray anything according to his will, he hears us. Could be the prayers we pray and have prayed for a year, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there seems to be no breakthrough. Could be we are not praying according to the will of God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. So may God help us. So from now as we are going out, there are the three things we talked about. And I want us to believe God that we will pray God's prayer. We will feel God's feelings. We will think God's thoughts and pray according to the will of God. And above everything, may you ask the Holy Spirit to come in you, in your hearts, and to minister to you how you're going to pray. Because ukifanya kitu kenye unajua ni rahisi sana kuliko kufanya kitu kenye unajui. Right? Inakuwa rahisi. Na si Roho Mtakatifu atusaidie kuweza kuomba. This week we get into the days of prayer. Those people who are fasting tomorrow, and those who are doing Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. May God help every one of us to take your day and be faithful and pray God's will. And if you realize, most of the prayer that we have, prayer items are open up to me every day. If you read the scripture that we are saying as well, you realize that we know this is the will of God. Yeah, this is the will of God. Just close your eyes and go before God as we finish and tell God, Father, from today, help me to know your will. I know maybe there's another question that will come. Then how do I know the will of God in this? We will look into that. I just go before him. Before then, mwambie Mungu, nifunze, nisaidie kujua mapenzi yako. Nifunze kujua ama kuomba kulingana na mapenzi yako. Nisiombe tu. Nisijikuze tu ninaenda mahali pa kuomba na ninalala ama ninakosa na ninakosa maneno ya kusema. Mwambie Bwana akufunze in Jesus' name. Our God and our Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so grateful. And I want to pray that you're going to help us, oh God, you're going to minister to our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. May you help us, dear Father, to understand the power in prayer. Prayer is such powerful that when we pray in accordance to your will, you answer us and you do great and amazing things. It is through prayer that we are receiving things. It is through prayer that we are breaking forces of evil. It is through the power of prayer that we are setting captives free. It is through the power of prayer that we are getting the peace of God that we need in our hearts. And so in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that everybody who has had this message, may the word of God minister to them, and may the Holy Spirit equip everyone, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, we praise you. This week we are getting out there, my Father, in the place of prayer and fasting as well. We pray for more grace. And we pray that we are not going to pray amiss in the name of Jesus Christ. Help us and walk with us in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray and we give thanks. Kwa jina la Jesus Christo, tumeomba na tumeamini. Amen. Thank you so much.